You know that story about how the maximum playing time of a compact disc of 74 minutes was specifically chosen to fit Beethoven's Ninth Symphony?
The compact disc was originally designed to have enough playing time to hold one classical music piece. Nutcracker Suite, Vivaldi's The Four Seasons, Rigoletto, Beethoven's Symphony Number 9.
Final answer?
Sure.
For $250,000?
Get me there.
Yes, Carrie! Yeah!
Well, it's a myth, or at least it's never been proven. When the compact disc was first introduced to Western markets in 1983, both Philips and Sony only advertised it as containing 60 minutes of music, not 74.
Take the new compact disc. 1 hour of Mozart out of a beer mat. Pure sound played by laser. Just listen to that. No hisses and crackles, of course, but if you do want that, munch a biscuit, sip a cup of cocoa, and it'll sound just like your old record player. You know what I mean?
And in fact, most recordings of the Ninth Symphony are only around 66 minutes long. But nonetheless, the first generation of recordable CDs had a maximum length of 74 minutes, or a data capacity of 650 megabytes. Then later, they were able to increase it to a maximum length of 80 minutes, or a capacity of 700 megabytes, which is still the most common capacity of recordable CDs you can find today. But have you ever seen this? Recordable CDs, which can fit up to 99 minutes of music, or 850 megabytes of data. Well, the key thing on this is it says records up to 99 minutes with some writers. I've seen 99-minute CDRs before, but only from the Banana brand, which I've never seen in person. So it was quite a surprise to come across a box of this at the thrift store from CompUSA, an official store brand of 99-minute CDRs. And unfortunately, I didn't get the full box full of them, because most of these are just empty, but I did get four of these 99-minute CDRs, so I'm going to have a try at recording 99 minutes of music on these discs. As it says, only some writers are capable of recording up to 99 minutes on these discs. Luckily, it's quite easy to find a website listing which mix and models are known to work, so for about $10 plus shipping on eBay, I was able to find one of them and install it in this Compact Desk Pro EN.
Check this out! I am watching BlogTV on a compact freaking Desk Pro EN.
It wouldn't be my Desk Pro now, would it?
No, it's not.
It's an LG model CED8080B, no relation to the failed RCA video disc format. And that website says ROM version 1.00 and higher is known to work. This one's ROM version 1.04. It was made in February 2001. It's just a CD drive. It does not read or write DVDs, but for a Pentium 3 system like this that's running Windows 2000, that's perfectly fine. And the reason why these 99-minute CDRs only work in some drives is because, as Wikipedia says, even the now standard 80-minute discs are made by molding the disc at the tightest allowable tolerances specified in the Orange Book CDR and CDRW standards. And they do mention the 90-minute and 99-minute discs, although they are less common and depart from the Orange Book standard. In order to use the additional capacity, these discs have to be burned using overburn options in the CD recording software. Overburning itself is so named because it is outside the written standards, but due to market demand, it has nonetheless become a de facto standard function in most CD writing drives and software for them. And regardless of the length, the maximum number of tracks you can put on a CD is 99. I have this CD that claims to have 101 digital sound effects, but it actually only has 98 tracks on the disc, and it employs the rarely used index marks to fit the last four sound effects on the last track. There is a website of one person who reported being able to burn just over 100 minutes of music to one of these 99-minute CDRs. But I consider that to be cheating because CD players only have a two-digit display for the minutes. So if you go over 99 minutes, it will either wrap around and show a negative number, or it'll just give an error and refuse to read the disc. And there are CDRs which claim to have a capacity of 100 minutes or 900 megabytes. And I think they're just rounding up from 99 minutes and 59 seconds. So they're probably actually the same as 99-minute CDRs. And as far as I can tell, there have never been any rewritable CDRW discs with a rated capacity greater than 80 minutes. So the 99-minute discs are write-only. They're not rewritable. Before you go burning one of those 99-minute discs, only to find out your drive doesn't support it, there's an old program you can use to test both the capabilities of your CD burner drive and the disc itself called Nero CD DVD Speed. First, you go into the options under transfer rate and you enable Overburn CD, and it's set to 99 minutes and 57.7 seconds. Then you can go to the overburning test. I'm going to try overburning it to 99 minutes and 57 seconds. And according to that list on that website I showed earlier, this drive is only capable of burning a 99-minute CD at 4x speed, so that's what I'll choose. And this is only going to test the disc, it's not actually going to write any data to it. For example, I tested one of these standard, totally labelless 80-minute CDRs made by Taiyo Yuden, which is a division of JVC, and it says the writing stopped at 82 minutes and 49 seconds, which is pretty much to be expected. It can only overburn a few more minutes than the CD's official capacity. And sure enough, when I go to play the disc in a standard CD player, the playback stops and starts to skip at exactly that point. Now I'm actually going to try testing one of these 99-minute CDRs, so I'll have to unwrap it for the first time in probably 20 years. See if it's still good. Ooh, it's a gold color. Claims to support up to 16x speed, but I doubt we'll get anywhere close to that if we want to have the full 99-minute capacity. But it says 99-minute, 850 megabytes, CD recordable, and it has the official compact disc recordable logo on it, even though it's not supposed to because it does not officially conform to the Orange Book standard for recordable CDs. So here we go, putting in the 99-minute CDR. It still only shows a capacity of about 80 minutes because there is no official standard beyond that point. But let's test it. I'm going to choose the 4x speed, so this will take quite a while. And I'll change that back to 99 minutes and 57.74 seconds and start the test. Okay, about 26 minutes later it finished, and it says it stopped without an error. So this disc and drive is capable of burning 99 minutes. Now to actually burn the disc, I'm going to use Nero Burning ROM version 5.5.7.8. And here I have 99 WAV files, which I ripped from the Backtracks music library, which I did a video about a while back. And I can start dragging and dropping them into the playlist here. But the annoying thing is that Nero automatically adds a 2-second gap between each track. I think that was originally necessary with the early CD burner drives. You had to leave a small gap between each track to let the laser cool down and to let the program buffer the next audio file. But with this drive and this system, it's not necessary. So I can go over here and do a select all and drag it over here. And then select all those and change that pause to 0 seconds. Except the very first track, because it's necessary to have that 2-second pre-gap before the very first track of the CD, so I'll change that one to 2. And here it says the disc is empty, so that test burn did not actually write any data to it. But first, before we actually burn the disc, we have to go into the preferences under expert features and enable overburn and change it from 82 minutes to 100 minutes. So now we can actually click the button to burn the disc. Set to 4x, disc at once. And we're going to be burning 99 minutes and 4.44 seconds, 1,000 megabytes, 99 tracks. So here we go, writing it. And it gives us a warning, do you want to try overburn writing at your own risk? This might cause read errors at the end of the CD, or might even damage your recorder. Warning, burning more than 95 minutes may result in unreadable data on some drives. So we'll ignore the warnings and go full speed ahead. Writing the overburn CD. Well, we have a failure here. It got to an invalid write state, and then it said, could not perform end of disk at once. Burn process failed at 4x. Despite that error when burning it, I'm going to try playing this 99-minute, 99-track test CD. The first benchmark CD player I'm going to use is this Technics SLPG-300 from 1992. So, recordable CDs didn't even exist yet when this was made, especially not ones that are 99 minutes in length. Give it a few seconds to spin up and read the disc, and it says 99 tracks, 99 minutes and 4 seconds. So let's give it a try. Well, despite that error when I was burning the disc, we were able to play the CD all the way to the end, and it sounded fine. So I'm going to try playing this CD in a variety of different players to see how well they do at playing this 99-track, 99-minute CD. Now let's try this cheap Lennox Sound portable CD player from 2000. Put in our 99-minute recorded CD. It's spinning up. And it says 99 tracks and 99 minutes and 4 seconds. So let's try playing it all the way to the end. It's a rainy fall day, and I'm in my 2018 VW Jetta to try playing this 99-minute CD in its car radio. It's reading the CD. And there it goes playing. I'll bring up the list of tracks, which I can scroll through. Let's just pick track 70. Okay, let's go to the last few tracks here. Track 95. 96. 97. 98. And now track 99. And there it's repeating over a track one, so it was able to play the entire CD all the way up to the 99-minute mark where it finished. So this 99-minute CD works fine in my car radio. I just pulled this old General Electric boombox out of a dusty corner of my basement. Not even going to clean it. I'm just going to try playing the CD. It's spinning up. If you can even read it, it says 99 tracks, 99 minutes and 4 seconds. So here I go playing it. So I think if this incredibly dirty old boombox can play a 99-minute CD, then shouldn't have any problem with any kind of CD player. You may wonder if it's possible to use a Mac to burn a 99-minute CD, and I'm wondering too. So here is the 2008 iMac I'm using to edit this video. I have a program for macOS called Burn. Under the preferences, I have it set to 900 megabytes, 99 minutes as the default CD media. Under advanced, I have allow overburning enabled. Here's my playlist of 99 tracks. I'll drag and drop that into the burn program. It says the total time is 1 hour, 39 minutes, and 3 seconds. So I'll stick in the 99-minute CDR. A little bit awkward to get to on this side, but it's doable. Now I'm ready to click on burn. I'll choose 8x speed, which is the lowest it can go, and burn. And we'll see what happens.
A little longer than a few minutes later.
Now it just popped out the disc and it briefly flashed a message saying the burn was successful. So let's try playing this 99-minute CD burned on a Mac. So here's the 99-minute CD I burned using the built-in drive in my iMac. I'm going to try playing it in this little CD player. Unique thing about this one is about the same size as a Discman, but it has built-in speakers. They don't sound very good, but at least we can hear what the disc sounds like. Here it is playing track 99. I had the tracks in a different order when I burned them on the Mac, so that's why it's a different song this time. I'm going to try moving it around, and it's not even skipping. So there's those built-in speakers. So yes, it is possible to burn a 99-minute CD on a Mac using its built-in drive at 8x speed, so that's pretty good. So I think this goes to show what a remarkable invention the compact disc was, since they were able to create a recordable version of it and extend its playing time by 25 minutes while retaining full compatibility with existing players. And to this day, 40 years after its release, is still the best-sounding pre-recorded music format to gain widespread acceptance in the consumer market. Today, most people are actually listening to lower quality music formats, such as with online streaming services, which use lossy compression, including the video you're watching now. So Philips and Sony really got things right when they invented the compact disc.